Hello everyone, welcome to Patsan TV. In today's speedrun video, we're gonna make a renovation together. It's actually another collaboration with the Plant Gamer. I hope you will enjoy it. So, if you're ready, let's game, shall we? Okay, so this is our plan. I gave him only these two points, like it has to be a two floors house with an attic if you want, and it has to be at the 20 to 30 size lot, and the rest is up to you. Our mission is going to be renovating an house. So we thought that this is an old house, and then it belongs to a family, like a father and mother and their children. That's the where the children are grew up with. So this is the parents' room. It's their bathroom, and there's another bathroom, toilet and shower in the second floor, and they're very boring, sorry Michael, very boring bedrooms. But I wanted that, like it had to be renovated later on. So we are also thinking that this is like an old time, that's why it shouldn't have proper electronical devices. So it makes sense. By the way, if you didn't know, maybe you know him as Michael Modish on Instagram. He recently made a name change, so I will put his Sims Gallery ID on the description as well, so you can go ahead and check there as well. And this is how he came up with as the house. And is there something in the attic? Yeah, he also put something in the attic, and also there is a garage as an extra. So this is the second floor, this is the first floor plan that he did. So you enter from here. Why don't we look from top here? My bad, sorry. This is the study, and there is a kitchen, and a dining table, and very tiny bathroom here. And in this house, like, I really liked how he designed in this area, and it's so realistic to me. And this is the garage door he thought of, and he created this kind of garage area and the backyard. You can enter like this. And he put a tree down here as well. I really like the idea of using a ladder here, but I cannot see the ladder right now. What happened to the ladder? Ladder, where are you? I think it is deleted. There is a ladder here. Trust me, there is one. Yes, there's a ladder here. So he dedicated this place to the ladder, and I really like this idea, and I started to use in my own buildings as well. He is a really good builder in The Sims, so I really enjoy seeing his designs, and it's always inspiring me. Actually, like this design that I, this house that I've done during my live sessions that are done in Turkish though, but it was a timer challenge. And I did this and decorated inside only in 10 minutes. And that week, the previous weekend, he was doing a similar fashioned houses, like stack of some container houses. And that inspired me, and I really had fun. And I'm gonna put its link on top there, here. But probably since it's in Turkish, you should turn on the subtitles. Other than that, yeah, this is the one that I done in 15 minutes. Anyways, let's go back to our topic. Yes. So this is the house, and the mission is he's gonna renovate the house, and he's gonna leave the interior design completely up to me. I'm gonna do it today, and I'm gonna show you the speed run. Okay, let's go and check the updated house. So he renovated. So we thought that maybe the children left the house after some time, and then the parents started to live by themselves. This is the design he came up with. It's in the night time. Okay, let's convert. And he put a car only. He did the things in the outside. He changed the fences. He changed the rooftop into iron roof. It's really nice. I really liked it. It's really good job, Michael. You did amazing job here. I love it. And he also put a very modernistic platform trick here. And he put these like a small couches here. And the second floor plan is more or less like this. Like he left the toilets alone. And then he left the walls as the same. He just changed the windows, but Other than that, I can just break some walls and do some drastic renovations in this house, which I'm planning to do. I played around a bit with this house. Ah, you see the ladder, right? So I was right. In this previous house, the ladder was deleted somehow. Yeah, it seems does that. And it also has some solar panels, so it's like a eco house. And he deleted the things in the attic as well. So if possible, I'd like to use the attic as a functional place as well. So hopefully you're gonna enjoy what I'm gonna do. So if you're ready, let's start to speedrun! So I started to make my interior design mostly by putting some lights, big lights. That's why I removed all the lights that he put, and I tried to remove the walls as much as possible. I just left the toilet's place around the same. And I removed the extra toilet in the second floor, thinking that like maybe they don't need that anymore. And then in the end, I will realize that it is a very stupid idea, but we will come to that. Yeah. And I had a floor plan in my mind. I played with this house a bit before, no lie here, but I didn't like decorate everything. Like I just started to decide where to put what, and I really wanted to have that sunken living room, because the sunken living room equals to a very rich modern house in my head. I don't know if you would agree with me or not, but it's like that for me. So I wanted to give them that, and I wanted to put a drastic color, so I chose the dark red. And I tried to make it look good. Actually, with the dark red, you cannot make so good designs. Knowing that, I tried to make my best. I tried to push myself out of the comfort zone. That's most of my aim, actually. And I wanted to change the fireplace into a more modern one. And in here, you're seeing me struggling with the red wallpapers. And I wanted to put some different things here and there, but in the garage I wanted to give some plain color in the end, like just white plain color. Other than that, everything, every place has their own unique floors, unique floors are sometimes same, yeah. The wallpapers are kind of unique and changing according to the place that I'm thinking of. So the kitchen, dining room, and the living room are kind of interconnected. There's only a passage from dinner place to the living room. And you're seeing me struggling with the kitchen right now. I think this is the build that I spent the most of my time in the kitchen counters. Like when I put the kitchen counters, it's like I double check if there's a top shelf as well. If there's no top shelves, I barely use. It's one condition. And other than that, I try to match the colors. And if I have a place for an oven, a place to cook, and a refrigerator, that's it for me. It's really straightforward for me how to make the kitchen. But since I wanted to make a hallway kind of kitchen, like you enter a room and that's a kitchen, I wanted to give proper space, and I wanted to give proper amounts of counters so that your Sims can actually use them. And for some reason I didn't like push them till the end. I don't know if you don't like, I remembered now. So refrigerator doesn't come in between those long windows, and I didn't want to change anything related to exterior design. It's up to Michael. That's why I didn't want to touch them. So I tried my best inside. I think it's a really nice looking place when you're looking outside, and there are like much, much worse examples in the real life. So this is a really normal thing, I think, I thought. And then I tried to challenge it, like I shouldn't be changing any kind of stuff and I should be renovating. And it should look still good. That was my objective. And in the second floor's You may remember that there were boys' room, and I just cut the demolished the wall in between, and I converted that into one hobby room because I got rid of the study room in the first floor as well. And I gave the same kind of ladder going to the attic. I didn't change its place, and instead of that second bathroom in the second floor, I gave more space to the wardrobe, like for their bigger clothes and stuff. I don't know. And when I was doing this dining place, I put one table, and it was from Snowy Escape, and it just suddenly came to my mind. I thought that these parents, after they got retired, they went to Mountain Komorebi, and they loved it, and they wanted to own the culture. So they were like buying the things like those little curtains with the bamboos on it. There's some little furniture just to put some decorations here and there. But they didn't have enough money to decorate whole house in the Japanese modernistic style. And that's where their sons came. That's how I imagined it. I like to imagine like that. And I like to imagine that their ideas are contradicting as well. So there are some more modernistic, more strongly felt places, like a very dark red, or the outside is also like super modernistic. You wouldn't expect that from an old couple wanting to be there. But the children forced them to do it, kind of like. They were like keep saying, oh, there will be pool there, or there will be a red living room, sunken living room, of course. They will be like that. I was imagining like that, and imagining this was really fun for me. And I really like that idea that TV is kind of low, so that in a sunken place, when you look at it, the TV is kind of lower, so that you understand, oh, all the furniture is kind of down, right? So I like that idea. And then when I was doing that, I realized that the upper side of the TV is kind of empty, so I had to put something there. So I decided to put some counters, and I never done that done that style before. Like I never tried to make a TV unit before, so it was first for me. And when I was doing, I was like trying to put like this or this, this or that, and somehow I combined two of them, and it looks so nice. So if you liked how it looks as well, please go and download my file. I don't remember which counters were those, but I used those thinner ones, top shelves as well, and I combined two different styles into one. I think in one I used the cool kitchen stuff, in one I used the base game stuff. They're both black, and when you combine them, they look so good. Like they look different, at least. I don't know. I exaggerated a bit much, maybe. And these are the decorations that I was talking about. They put them on the top because they didn't want to get rid of that, obviously, because they didn't want their parents to get sad about those. Like if they get rid of them, no. I also thought that this woman has to have knitting skill. And yeah, these are the TV unit part. And at this part, right at this part, my video got a problem, and I couldn't record properly. But you will be able to see soon. Yeah, it's coming. So I put those art lights as well under it, so that it gives that very cool looking and stuff. I wanted to make it like a asymmetric style, because I like to do so. I think there is no obvious reason for that. You can do all sorts of things, you know, it seems. So yeah. And when I was trying to decide what to put in that wall, I suddenly made up a story, a little story here. It's a sad story, get ready for that. After the children left the house, these parents bought a dog, and that dog, Cookie, died. And in the memory of that, they put that statue looking at the directing at the TV because it liked the he liked the looking at the TV all the time. That's why they wanted to commemorate this dog. Yeah, sad. And I put some dog furniture to the attic as well because they couldn't get rid of them. I was like, when I was putting, I was like, this is so sad. Should I put like this? Really? I was like, why did I make myself sad when I'm doing this? I'm literally crying right now. Oh my God. By the way, I never had a pet. Like, we had a bird or something at those house. Other than that, I never had a pet. I don't know why I got so emotional about that. And other than that, this in the on this wall, there's a picture, and right under it, there is a wallflower that I've never used before. I really like to combine two of those. Like, I will be doing this all the time in my next build, so get ready for that. And I also put those frames, and it kind of ruined my life for like 3 or 2 or 4 hours. I'm so bad at this. I've never done this before. It just came to my mind that, oh, there should be family pictures here. And no, there shouldn't be family pictures. You don't have to make a family picture there. Stupid kid, what were you thinking? I don't even have the proper mods to get proper pictures. What was I thinking? And I created a family, created a house, put it in the old house, and then I took lots of pictures. I even created Cookie. Oh my God, I'm gonna cry. And Cookie was so cute, by the way. Anyways, I'm gonna show you those after the speed run. And what was I saying? Yeah, I created everyone. Then I took pictures just to put into those frames. And I thought for a while, how can I bring these things to the there? Because you cannot put those frames, all of them together in your inventory for one person. You have to put them individually, and the frame is there. You bring your sim down there, and you put them there. But at first, I was thinking that maybe I should move all the family here. But if I'd done that, they would just start to ruin things. You know, Sims are doing barbecue all the time, trying to cook all the time, and then doing crazy stuff. So I didn't want that. They might have break something. Like, although they own the house, they don't have the right to use the house right now because I don't allow it. Yes. And this is the, by the way, the entrance is sort of like a office lounge area because the guy is a retired famous archaeologist, I thought. And sometimes some journalists are coming and they're accepting them in this front place. And like, when you think like that, kitchen being close to the lounge area also makes sense to me. Made sense to me later on, but I'm just finding an excuse. Like, it's just a bare coincidence. But it was kind of fun to think like that, yes. And I wanted this place to look as modern as possible. I thought that like the suns created this area completely from 0 to 100, that lounge area. Other than that, like, the families were always like putting their comments and changing things, but in that lounge area, only the sons decided to do everything because it was the first place, and the families actually didn't like everything that much. That's why they started to put their thoughts on it, and they started to change things when they are renovating the house. Yeah, and in this house, since they're obsessed with the Mountain Komorebi culture, of course, you cannot enter the house with your shoes. Please don't enter houses with your shoes anymore. Like, the world, it's 2021. It really doesn't make sense. By the way, I grew up in the culture that we always take off our shoes at the entrance. In Turkey, it's very common application as well. And it's not common, it's like 100% everyone does that. So I never understood this logic. Europeans and Americans that I'm seeing in the series and movies, they're always entering the houses with their shoes. Like, why? Like, do you know how many times you need to clean that floor? Like, why do you do this to yourself? I will never understand. Like, maybe we are lazy, we don't want to clean the house that much, but yeah, please. Doesn't make sense that much. Please rethink. And try to apply this into your house as well. And they applied. Yes. Let's go back to our story. So in the hobby area, of course, there's flower arrangement area because I thought that the woman also likes to make some flower arrangements, the mother. And always when I was finishing one room, I had that idea that since this woman likes to make flower arrangements so bad, I had to put lots of flowers after the room is completed. So I was trying my best to put one or two plants here and there. And also, this is kind of giving some heads up to my collaborator today, the plant gamer. So he recently changed his nickname. That's why I wanted to honor his idea. He's also sharing beautiful plants on his Instagram. I couldn't talk. And everything's link will be down below. You can find everything from there. And our gallery addresses, our Instagrams and stuff. And in the garage, I didn't think that the garage is needed to be this long, so I decided to cut some part and make some laundry area. Because when I was finishing the living room, the kitchen and stuff, I suddenly realized that, oh, there's no laundry here. Where should I put the laundry? By the way, on Sims, you never have to make the laundry actually. It comes with the laundry pack. If you buy this pack, there are hampers and dryers and washing machines. If you put one of these at home, Sims start to care about this. And if your clothes is dirty, they feel like uncomfortable, sad all the time. It gives more problem than solution actually. But it makes it more fun actually, more realistic. The clothes can be wet, the clothes can be not clean enough. They care this kind of stuff. In case you wanna know. Yeah. I don't know why I thought this. And in the bedroom, of course, I had to put a bonsai tree with sakura and then some Japanese style unique furniture. And I created a place with some chair so that when the old parents are changing their clothes, they just sit down there and take care of their things over there, change their clothes over there. And other than that, I think I'm just gonna decorate the house a bit more and it's gonna end soon. I try to put Japanese looking things as much as possible after some point. Ah, there's attic, of course. I didn't do anything about the attic for right now. Yeah, I'm gonna come to there soon. So when I was doing the attic, I thought that like it would be fun to use the old items that Michael used in the previous house. So I thought that maybe they couldn't sell everything, or they didn't want to sell everything. They just put the beds and stuff to the attic and they never came. Actually, it doesn't make sense to me. How do you put the bed on the attic? But now that I think about it, yeah, it makes sense. It doesn't make sense that much. But maybe they disassembled it completely and assembled it there again for some reason. I don't know. Yeah, but they did it. Yes. And then they created this area like a another living area. It also has a like a opening bed from the tiny living pack. So if the children are coming home to visit, they can sleep only on in the attic. And I gave that little kitchen as well, so you're gonna see it soon. And in that kitchen, I realized that there is no coffee machine in this house. And I went back to the kitchen and I reorganized the stuff in the kitchen. And I'm putting there I go, putting another frame. Oh my God, why did I create this torment for myself? I spent so many times when I was trying to get those pictures. Okay, enough complaining. Okay, I know. Yeah, when I was putting the items that are like showing the personalities of the father and mother always had to have plants around and the father always had to have books around. That was the golden rule for me. And by the way, can I say once more how much I like the house's exterior? Like I was like keep just looking at it, like and admiring it. Oh, it looks so good. Oh, it looks so good. He thought like that. So good. I was like that all the time. Yeah, he's really talented. And like in the attic, I put these furnitures. Then accordingly, I try to push them next to each other as much as possible because they're dysfunctional anyways. And I wanted to put a TV, another chair, because why not? And some decorative items, some objects, random objects here and there. I was even considering to put a statue there. And then some boxes that are coming with the cats and dogs bag. And then, yeah, a little mini refrigerator and a microwave. So if they're getting hungry at night, they can use those stuff as well. So here I'm gonna put the coffee machine, and I will realize that, oh, there is no coffee machine. There is no dishwasher at this house. It had to be convenient. It shouldn't have to be like this. It shouldn't have to be like this. Yeah, I think more or less we're coming to the end. So I hope you guys enjoyed it, watching so far. And I'm gonna put more pictures on my Instagram, how we renovated each room from where to what. So if you like this video so far, make sure to leave comment and subscribe to my channel. And if you'd like to see more of these contents and then know about this content immediately, you can also hit the bell button, and then you will be knowing that I will be there for you all the time. And see you next week, guys. Bye.